I'm Mallory from Quebec Homestead, and recently I've been getting a lot of traction on my channel for this video. Am I doing this right? Okay. So what happened was the algorithm decided to push it out because it is an awesome video and it is a cheaper alternative to cattle panel. So for those that you don't know what I'm talking about, I'm gonna show a little clip of what it is. But for those that have seen the video and wanna know how it held up, this is gonna show you how it held up through the high winds, throughout the whole season. I'm gonna show you my tomatoes that were on it, how much it held. So stay tuned for all that good stuff, and yeah, subscribe. I've been wanting cattle panel forever, ever since I came across Roots and Refuge Farms garden on Pinterest and everything, and I was like, man, I want some of those. And unfortunately, they're just not accessible here. They are like from in between $60 to $70 each panel. And I'm like, well, I can't just go out and buy that. So I figured out something a little bit different. A subscriber of mine, Bettina, actually suggested that I use Remesh. So as I mentioned, I was looking for cattle panel and solutions for a long time, and everything was sold out in spring because thank you, COVID, right? So I had to figure out a different way, and that's what I ended up using. And I wasn't sure if it was gonna hold up to the high winds because we are up in elevation. I think we're about at like 570 meters, which is under 1500 feet elevation. But for here in Quebec, that's really high. We're up in the mountains. So we do have the plus of having the beautiful view, but we do have the downside of being fully exposed to all the elements. We do have a lot of sunshine because we have the southwest facing mountain, but the wind is just crazy. Our dominant winds come from the west and it's straight on to the garden. So that's why I've been trying to do these little intimacy fences and trying to figure out windbreaks naturally with the bushes and stuff. I've been working on that. It's work in progress. But we do get very high winds, up to 100 kilometers an hour. The trellises held up very, very well with the high winds, and I didn't add in any other support than what we saw in the video. The rebar, half inch, was plenty enough to keep it solid, and I put it on the ground level, and the stakes were about, I would say, almost a foot in the ground. And I didn't do anything extra. They just were tied on there with a tie onto the rebar, and it did excellent. So I'm really, really happy with that. What did help though was I did overlap the panels about 6 inches on top of each other, and I put the rebar in between the bars. So that really helped it solidify, and then I tied it up with some extra wire. It was great. Maybe something that really helped as well is that I did plant corn on the other side of my tomatoes. So that maybe helped a little bit for the windbreak. But in all, like seriously, I had a lot of wind before the corn grew high enough to really protect it. And the corn was actually on their side as well too. We had like a really big mini hurricane and everything was on the ground except for my tomatoes. So next year I will definitely look into treating them, washing them all down, removing the rust, and painting them. I think white would be awesome. I think white would be an awesome color to have them. It would like really pop out. Who knows, maybe I'll paint them pink, I don't know. But I think it would really help for the duration, like of the lifespan of the panels, because they do rust quite a bit. As you see in that video that I did, the rust was rubbing off on the plant. For the rust, it did not harm the plant at all. It didn't do anything. And one other thing that I did with my tomatoes is that I weave them through the squares. And I think that did a lot of rubbing. Some of them actually with the high winds sort of got a little bit damaged. So next year I'm definitely going to be looking into investing in those little clips that you just clip around the stalk and then onto the panel. And I think that'll prevent a lot of the rubbing and stuff. And I had a kink in my neck for 2 weeks during that summer. So I did spend 2 weeks no weeding, just doing this trick minimum, and when I came back into the garden, they had grown so much. So weaving them in there, when they grow like a foot, sometimes the tops can snap off, so you really got to stay on top of it. Another interesting thing that I made with these panels, the remesh panels, was an arched trellis. And I unfortunately planted a little bit too late along. I planted some morning glories. I wanted to have some beautiful flowers on there because the plan was to get married in my garden this summer. Thanks COVID again. It was canceled. So the morning glories didn't quite get up there, and there was not enough compost in that section of the garden. I had just created it and I just destroyed the integrity of the soil, and so I wasn't expecting much production out of it, but I still was very, very satisfied with the arch trellis that I made. So next year I planted some vines this fall along this arch trellis, and I really hope that it will grow up there. I also have a rose bush, but I'm not sure if it's a climbing rose bush. I'm really gonna have to keep you guys posted on that.